Hi Capricorn, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and let's do your love read now. Let's see what's going on in your love life, Capricorn, now. How you're feeling, how your partner's doing, and what you need to say to each other, and what guidance and advice we can get regarding your love life now. And these are general collective readings, Capricorn, will not resonate with each and every one of you. So take what works for you and just leave the rest. So let's begin. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for my Capricorn gang and send them the messages they need to hear the most about their love life now. Thank you. So Capricorn, as always, let's start with the angel blessing card to top the reading. See what my angels have for you and then we'll begin. So my angels, a blessing, advice or a message card for my Capricorn, please. Blessing, advice or a message card for my Capricorn, please. Thank you. Okay, so this one. All right, we'll keep this one here, Capricorn. Put the rest back. And let's see what there is for you here. Triumphant. All right. So I think some kind of victory is in store for you, Capricorn, here. Let's keep this card here and see why you're going to be triumphant in love now. So welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here. Thank you for all your love and support. Thank you for all your donations, likes, comments. Very, very blessed to have you all here today. Thank you so much. And if you're new here, we welcome you to our Omkara family. Do join us, subscribe to the channel and become part of us. We welcome you in. So Capricorn, newbies, I'll be setting down two sets of cards here. One is for you, one is for your partner. And in the center, I'll have your mutual energies to see how you got your energies are combining, any advice or any message that you may need. And of course, we'll do some dialogue messages as well to see what your partner would like to say to you now or what you'd like to say to your partner. And if any of you need a private reading, Capricorn, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. Bottom of my deck, Capricorn, I also see the Queen of Swords. So this is a queen who is in power, yes, but is quite strict, okay? They don't think with their heart. They think more with their analytical brain, and they are little unemotional, I would say, from what the feel that I get here. Or maybe just somebody who knows what they want and they want what they want, right? So Capricorn, let's start with some dialogue messages between you and your partner. Let's see if you could say something, what would that be? So Spirit, what would Capricorn and their partner like to say to each other now? One more. Oops. All right, two more. Great. Let's take three more from another deck here, Capricorn. Messages between Capricorn and their person. One more. Wonderful. Thank you. So the first card I have here for you here, Capricorn, it says, my heart breaks a little bit more every day we are apart. So you guys are in separation, it seems, and somebody, at least one person, is really missing the other and saying, my heart is breaking because we're not together anymore, or at least at the moment. Second card says, this relationship seems more like a situationship right now. I feel like you're taking my love for granted. Maybe words have not been expressed, or one person is, like I said, a little bit too much in their head space and not so much in their heart space, is not showing the love that their partner wants. So it's seeming more like a situationship now instead of a loving relationship. And somebody feels that, hey, I loved you, but you know, I feel that you're taking my love for granted here. Next card. I knew from the first time that I saw you that I would love you forever. Your smile made me fall in love with you, and I knew then that I wanted to wake up to see your smile every day. So this is one partner who's quite in love, but I have a feeling that the other one is kind of not on the same page here. Let's see. It drives me crazy how you manage to read my mind and hijack my thoughts. How do you know everything? I can't hide anything from you. So I don't know how the other partners, you know, picking up. Maybe there's a soul connect, or maybe through tarot readings, trying to figure out what's going on in the other partner's mind, and it's freaking that partner out to, know that, hey, you know, it freaks me out that you know exactly where I am and what I'm doing and what I'm thinking at the moment. Next card. I write you messages and then I delete them because I just don't know what to say. I'm so sorry because I know that my silence is hurting you. I am healing and trying to find my strength to be honest with you about how I truly feel. So like I said, there could be separation. Maybe there is no reciprocity right now. One person is saying, hey, you're taking me for granted, and the other person doesn't know how to tell the truth. Whatever their truth is, whatever they feel, they can't right now express to their person. They feel, I do try and write messages, but then I don't know what to say. And I'm sorry about that. I'm sorry about my hurting you. Next card. I get so triggered seeing you do things for the karmic that I want you to do for me. It pisses me off because we should be together. Why are you wasting time? So yes, maybe one partner has gone off to be with somebody else, and the partner who's missing them or feeling getting taken granted, their love getting taken granted for, is saying, why do you have to be with anyone else when I'm there, right? It hurts me that whatever you're doing for your partner, you should be doing for me. And we should be together, and we're just wasting time on other people. Next card. I just want to hold you now. It's been so long. It's been too long since you held me close, and I'm aching for you. So that's the story here, Capricorn. If this is your story, let's open your cards and see how it's going to go. So for me, Capricorn, this is person A, this is person B, right? So you decide which side you are resonating best with. So for person A, Cappies, the first card I have is the Six of Pentacles, Six of Swords, Five of Pentacles, Five of Cups, Ace of Wands, and the Ten of Pentacles. Beautiful. Okay, next. Person B has the Nine of Cups, Knight of Swords, Hierophant, Ten of Wands, Four of Cups, and the Queen of Wands. Yes, okay, so let's start with the energies of person A, Capricorn. On person A side, I think they were looking for equal give and take. They wanted a partner who would, you know, kind of love them, and they could love them back. And they thought, okay, this is the ideal situation where I can now not be in a troubled alone self of my own, and maybe be able to move ahead with a partner now where I can have a constant partner. I can have equal give and take. We can be happy and peaceful together. But something happened here, Capricorn. There was no justice to be had here. Yes, somebody was not working towards bringing this equal give and take between the two of you, I think. And because of that, I think the scales got a bit imbalanced and there's no justice to be had. So much so that person A is now feeling absolutely abandoned, left out in the cold, feeling neglected, having a lot of regrets for the way things have not worked out between the two of you. So, Six of Swords, Spirit. What's the Six of Swords? Somebody walked away, I think, from here. Yeah, this something happened here, Capricorn, where things really came to an end. I think somebody emotionally manipulated the other person. This was quick, this was fast. If there was one day you guys could have been happy, and the other days, I mean, it was over. It was that quick and that fast. And person A is feeling emotionally manipulated, feeling that, okay, now I'm, you know, I have to now just heal myself, get over all this heartbreak, even though I'm feeling very sad, I'm feeling neglected, I'm feeling like somebody just dumped me here suddenly out the blue. And here I was trying to make a decision about being together forever, and my commitment is no longer on the table anymore. So a lot of sadness, a lot of regret, because somebody didn't make a decision, I think, to commit to them. Five of Cups, Spirit. Five of Cups. Yes, they're feeling sad about the way things didn't turn out in their favor. They're feeling bad that, you know, there was no new beginning to be had. But I think now some action is coming. Ace of Wands spirit for person A. I think after a period of feeling sad and after feeling, you know, being wrapped up in these memories that of this person who with whom things didn't work out, maybe because there was a fight, there was a conflict, maybe there was competition around this relationship, this has given person A absolutely no wish fulfillment. But I think now, slow and steady, person A is coming out of their sadness, of their depression. I think the worst is already over here for person A. They are trying to pick themselves up once again and move towards new love in their life. Okay. So let's see, what's this Ace of Wands spirit? Ace of Wands, is it new love or is it their old love coming back? I think certain secrets have now been revealed to person A. Things are out in the open, as now I don't think this person is waiting around anymore for this old person to come back. They are ready to now proceed ahead, find new love and find new stability with maybe somebody else in their life. They don't want to invest in something which hasn't worked out for them. They feel all these promises were all false promises, and whatever I have invested in has brought me no fruit, nothing of concrete value. I think person A is now coming out of their hermit mode and trying to manifest a brand new beginning for themselves, where they can have that love, they can have that beautiful new love and happiness once again in their life. Okay, and they will be triumphant from what I can see here. So let's see person B. Nine of Cups. What's this Nine of Cups? So they were happy as well. They were happy as well, but this person B was always holding back. They never really allowed themselves to enjoy or feel this wish fulfillment with person A, I think, in the past. Maybe something, yes, this is the person, this is the same card in the same position. Knight of Swords, Knight of Swords. So I think something kind of cut this relationship off even before it could begin. Why is that spirit? What's this Knight of Swords? Why was this person holding back? This was a complete cut off here, complete death to this relationship for some reason. Why was this spirit? Why is this death and Knight of Swords here in person B's side? I think the thought of a commitment or a long-term relationship became a little overburdening to this person. They wanted to have a new adventure, maybe move to newer horizons, or maybe they received a message from somebody, something that put a lot of burden on this person. And in a second, I think, this was like quite sudden, where this person just cut off from person A and put a death to this relationship. So what's this Hierophant spirit? What's this Hierophant? Hierophant. There was a full potential of a beautiful commitment here. There was a full commit. There was a potential. There was a offer maybe on the table. This person could have thought that, yes, I'm going to meet my equal match. But something ended here suddenly because of this big burden. I have this twice here for person B. And then a stagnation card and an ending card as well. So this must have been quick, fast. And something just kind of came to an end here. What's this Ten of Wands spirit? What happened here? Ten of Wands? Maybe they had other options here. Or maybe they got confused. Maybe they didn't want to be in a commitment. Maybe they wanted to check out other options. They felt too overburdened by maybe the thought of a long-term commitment. Something happened here where this person B started holding back here. Okay? So Four of Pentacles spirit, Four of Pentacles. They wanted to go and see what else was out there. They didn't want to be stuck in a place where, you know, there would be, this would turn into a marriage, or they would be have to be the wife. Maybe there was some news that they received or something which kind of changed their mind almost overnight. And now they held back. Yeah, they wanted to see what else was going. Yeah, see, again, Three of Wands and the Two of Wands. So at one point they may have been at crossroads deciding, but then they realize, hey, I have the world in my hands, let me go out there and see what else is out there for me. And that's the reason person B held back from person A. They look, coming across as the Queen of Wands. What's this Queen of Wands spirit? Queen of Wands? There is movement around them, but the two people around this Queen of Wands are not the best. So this could be the same person. Maybe somebody messaged them, somebody was keeping a watch on this Queen of Wands, who's very attractive, beautiful, nice, go-getter. Whoever this person is around this Queen of Wands is not the best person, because whoever this person is, either they felt that person A is like that towards them. I doubt it highly. I think this is somebody else who caught their eye. Look at this person. They caught their eye. They looked back at something. Maybe at somebody who was a player, is a player, who emotionally controls them. I don't know. What's this Queen of Wands spirit? Queen of Wands. Whoever this person is on person B's side, forget about who they went to, what they did, or what they're planning to do. The whole point is here that they didn't want to have any regrets. Okay, they didn't want to look back at the past with regrets. So I think they've kind of dropped fighting for the connection. They are no longer fighting for the connection. This Queen of Wands is on her mission to find something more. Okay. So this could be either, let's see, this is quite a heartless decision, I would say, because I did say somebody who's using their head over heart here and making a decision about something here. Let's see what your death, judgment, and the Ace of Swords. All right, so what's this death card spirit for Capricorn and that person? One more. There is some ending here, and whoever has done the wrong to their partner, they are going to be able to, the person who's the good one here, right, who hasn't run out on their partner here, they are going to stand strong here. They're going to be able to fight another day. Whereas the other person, I feel, they're going to suffer some kind of bad karma here. There is an ending to some fertility and growth in their life, where there's going to be a judgment call made on this person. The love is draining out. I think it's going to be a case of the grass was not greener on the other side either, and this person is soon going to realize, the person who left, who made the decision to leave, is going to realize that they've lost it all. They may be coming back for a rebirth also. Yeah, because wherever they went, I think wherever this person has gone, this has not really worked out for them. They're going to feel, come back, maybe feeling being abandoned and left out, wherever they went or whatever they did, is going to backfire on the person who has cut this beautiful relationship and gone off to look for greener pastures. Something is going to backfire here. There could be a return, and there is going to be maybe a clear communication here as well. Ace of Swords spirit, what's this Ace of Swords? Whenever this, if this communication comes, Capricorn, Yes, there could be some communication coming, or maybe you're looking for some communication. Whatever the scene, whatever you're going to find out, one way or the other, is going to, I don't think there's any balance coming here in this relationship very soon. Because of whatever one partner has done to the other, I think the love has gone now. That trust, that love, that feeling of soulmate connection, that's all gone here because somebody didn't do right. Somebody didn't bring justice and balance into a relationship. There's no more wish fulfillment to be had with this person who has been ruthless, I would say. Somebody has been very, very ruthless and taken somebody's love for granted here. Okay? So, yes, that's all I have for you. But whoever this person A is definitely, definitely going to now reap the benefits of their goodness. They're going to have all the tools available to them to manifest exactly what they were looking for. They're going to have love in their life and they're going to have stability and a long-term partnership coming towards them. Whether it's going to be with person B, I'm not so sure at the moment, Capricorn. Let this communication come. You can decide what you want to do. But from now that I see, right now, the love is kind of, there's no trust left here. There's no emotional happiness. There's no more love left because things have been very imbalanced in this connection. Okay? So, yes, there is triumphant news for person A here. That's my verdict. Person B has some lessons to learn here. So that's all I have for you, Capricorn. Love and light. Take care. Namaste.